so. Beautiful.
Nice.
Blended well.
Is that lighter gray area a little softer in there?
Just a touch.
Thank you. You want to show your platforms? I don't want to get it out of your rhythm, but... And show the flake that the flake that they're or the face that they're coming off of too, so you can see that. Yeah, that'll be a big help for him.
Just barely any room to remove a flake, but it's enough.
Yeah. What are you gonna do about this? If it, are you gonna?
Because I may have to blend it back in over here.
Yeah.
Because it's gonna hinge right there.
Yeah.
There's no way around that.
These are so nice.
Yeah. But I've got to get that one to thin this edge. So.
Yeah. Hopefully it'll just blend out and just kind of feather in there.
That would be nice if it'd do that.
Yeah.
Pressure off. I'll get it later with cleanup. Those base shots like that are so hard to get.
Yeah.
Until the end.
Nice. Really nice.
Yeah, I'm surprised it did as well as that.
Yeah, that was perfect.
That one not so good, but it's clean at least.
It came off pretty nice considering what it sounded like.
Yeah. Be nice if I whacked it hard enough and it came in clean.
Mm.
Hard to do that though.
Yeah, I see what you're thinking, and you've been striking so well. I'd back off on that one a little bit.
It almost did.
Yeah. Well, you're deep enough now to get your far enough in your ridge to blend it from the other side.
I've actually got enough of a ridge to go get those two right there.
Yeah, that's what it is. That's probably about 5 millimeters, isn't it?
Pretty close, yeah. It's got a few thick spots, but... it's getting darn thin.
Is that a Mark Bracken moose pad?
I'm not sure who it is. I got it from a buddy of mine, Daniel Tompkins, in Georgia. I used to have just a little deer pad, wore all the pieces, and he said, here, you need a new pad.
That's a nice pad.
Yeah. Can't remember if it's buffalo or moose. I think it's buffalo. Well, Mike Smith from Oklahoma gets them in a lot. Loves them.
Likes the buffalo?
Yeah.
He does a lot of that noodling. I bet there's so much water. I bet his favorite noodle holes are pretty full right now.
Yeah. Clean the edge up, but they ruined the middle.
Oh, ruin is a strong word.
I'll get a few more here, and maybe come back and see if we can't get that. It's going to start taking on more of an Aztec-shaped blade, because I'm having to narrow this up so much.
Oh, still look catted with nice, you know?
Yep.
So you said the sweet water, though, is farther from the caddo stuff,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, from what I understand, anyway, most of the caddo is northeast Texas. This was found in west Texas, out west of Abilene. Near the cap rock, almost southern edge of the cap rock, anyways. Thank you.
Well, that one's just bound to hinge up on me.
I hope one of these days they find a solid piece of copper like that in a dry rock shelter.
Wouldn't that be something?
Buried with a stack of ultra-thin blades.
That would be interesting, wouldn't it?
Yeah. People need... A whole lot of people are hungry for some vindication.
You know, if I bury myself in a rock shelter with all my points and tools, you know, in 1,000 years they'll find one.
Well, we ought to just take you somewhere out and haul you up a really dry mountain so they can see what you look like.
There we go. Oh, that'd be scary.
Yeah. Some of those ice mummies are actually pretty attractive looking, which is sick for me to admit, but you can tell that they were.
Yep.
You know, there's that one lady that's buried. You can tell that she was a beautiful, important in time. She just sort of... Looks like some of those ladies in Hollywood now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they weren't much different than us. My eyes are having trouble focusing.
Nice.
That one went well.
Oh, focus pretty good there.
There you got take that rippling out in the middle.
Go to the ophthalmologist and he holds up blades from far away. Can you see that platform? Can you see that platform? Or what if you go to the DMV and you look in and you have to look at it? Could you hit that? Could you hit that?
I'm going to tweak this platform just a little bit. It's got a corner that's a little low. All that was needed. important flight. Oh, I hit wrong. Hit over to the side.
Just to the right a little bit?
Yeah.
Do you have room right below it to curl up in there?
Not really.
Yeah, it's a little flat in it.
Maybe after I come back and do this one, I might.
You run out of ridges when you chip them that thin, Curtis.
Yeah. Yeah. You run out of options real quick.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to move into the sun or?
No, this is good right here. There's no shadows.
Yeah.
What in the world? That was a good solid hit too. It failed on me. I must have dove it too much or something.
There's a little flake in here that's...
Oh, yeah.
Pretty.
Maybe it was messing me up, huh?
Yeah, this one right there looks like it would be a real platform crusher. It's pretty amazing how deep they can get in there.
Yeah. Probably part of it too is I don't dress it as often as I probably should. I think my edge is just too thin to be able to reach out in there and get them. I don't want to narrow it up anymore. Yep. Just too thin to get out in there.
Well, that's still a really nice blade.
Enough thickness still right there though to try for that one. I'll give it one more go, and if it don't go, then pressure flake it up and call it good. Nice and thin, but there's a few of those uglies out in there. Once they get thin like this, it's hard to fix those.
I have one wonder. We were talking about the doing, you know, several guys like making platforms and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And I wonder if some of the stuff couldn't be decided by committee, you know? Like,
yeah.
Somebody says, oh, I'm gonna hit that platform. And then another guy said, nope, no, you're not.
Yeah.
You know, and then.
There are times that I could use that.
There's an overrule, you know.
I've got buddies who nap with me say, you shouldn't hit that. I told you shouldn't hit that. I'm a little stubborn though.
Well, sometimes, you know, you can get away with stuff. And so.
Yeah.
But.
Okay, get my electric Indian after that sucker.
Oh, your grinder thing?
Yeah, I don't have one, but I'll just grind the pee out of it. Yeah. If I can get this, this will be okay. It'll be acceptable. Just a little bit more.
There sounded good.
That one went.
Beautiful.
Now if I can follow suit with this next one.
Got some good close-ups of that little platform prep. Wish I could see the grinding much better, but it's okay. You don't have to get uncomfortable with it. People need to see on the. They think that, you know, like you were talking about the lateral grinders, yeah. You know, just the swipers. They don't see all the little brushing up and down and shaping on the platform you're doing.
Well, I do. Looking on that sloofing video where he was doing the
dorsal ridge
abrasion. Yeah, and I do that a lot, but what I do it for is for shaping and making sure it doesn't have that little lip from those negative bulbs, because that will give what I call a false platform. You'll hit too low on it and it'll just hinge. I've done that a few times already. It was for educational purposes, yeah.
I think that you had on a couple of those flakes. I think that you were getting crunchy in your bar. Really? Had a flake in it, yeah.
Yeah.
Ah, that spot just doesn't want to go. Get out in there and pick it off. Maybe when I do this plate, maybe it'll go up in there. But it went over and hinged on this side.
Well, you could throw that off a bridge and it would take a long time to hit the bottom. What's that then?
It'd just float, huh?
Mm-hmm.
That because it's going out on that flat surface and that'll spread way too quick. And pressure flaking. Get some good low narrow flakes. That'll work. It'll go out and widen out, but it won't do it so quick. I hope. Well, there's a little crystal pocket right here that shows light through it.
Cool.
I didn't notice that until I just turned it. It went wide like I was hoping it would, but it turned up, went too deep. Must be something right out in here that's stopping it.
That's, yeah, that was unusual.
Well, you know what? I could probably pressure flake and set up another platform right there. Weird how it did that.
That one's gonna, you're gonna have to hit that towards your tip a little bit. Like that. That's gonna be a tricky one.
Spot just does not want to be flaked.
Still very, very impressive.
Yeah, I think I'll pressure flake it up. All it done, it's got some uglies in it, but it is nice and thin.
Let's get it in light and show it.
See through in the middle a little bit.
Is it shadow? My head is in the way. There we go. Oh, there it is. Yeah, hold it sideways.
That this one thick spot's the...
It's pretty skinny, Curtis. I need to back off just a little there. It's pretty... It looks about... it's a 10-inch blade, wouldn't you say?
Pretty close, yeah.
9 3/4
9 or 10 inch.
Very nice. You're gonna do some edge work and blend in. I'll turn this off and then we can